Hello there. In this tutorial, we are going to learn basics of Keil Microvision compiler. Okay. So first, launch the Keil Microvision compiler. Okay. So let us start with a new project. Okay. That is project, new project. Okay. You can give some name for the project. Okay, let's say sample. Okay, that is the name of the project. Save. So at this stage, we have to select a target device. So our target device on the main board is Atmel 80. The name of the target device is 8089C51ED2. Select the target device and press OK. At this stage, you can say yes or no. What happens if you say no is that this configuration file, that is startup, will not be generated. This is not required for our programming purpose. So at that stage, you can say no. So this is not required. That's why I'm removing this file. Okay, fine now. So now we have to write a code. So the Keil Microvision compiler is basically a cross compiler. That is, the compiler writes Keil Microvision compiler. We can write a code for a target device working on another processor or a controller. So that's why it is known as a cross compiler. In this Keil Microvision compiler, we can write code either in assembly language programming or C language. Okay, fine. So to take an example, let us say we write a code in assembly language program. How to write a code? So for that, you can go to file, new, okay, or else you can find a shortcut here, new file. You can click on this. Okay. Fine. Let us say we write a simple code. That is, I am transferring a data to accumulator. Move a, hash 09h. Okay. End of the code. A simple code, just for understanding purpose. Okay. So let us say I have written a code. I have to save the code, the source code, as file save. Okay. Give some name to the the source code. There is no condition on the file name. You can give any name. Okay. That is a sample dot ESM. ESM because it is a assembly language code, and hence we have to write as dot ESM. If the code is in C language, you have to write the extension as dot C. There is file name dot C. Save the file. Okay. So after saving the file, you have to make this source code part of the project. Okay. So whatever we have created here, target. So we have to make this source code part of this project. To do that, right click on the source group and say add files to source group. That is the source group which is already created, that can be added to the project. Okay. So by default it shows C file, of course, C source file. You can change it to assembly, and you may find your code here. Okay. If there are many codes, you can search your code, no problem. Sample.esm, add. As soon as you click on that, you can see that the source code is added to the project, and you can say close. If you press add again, it will generate a message. Okay, so once you press on add, it will be automatically added to the project. Now close this window. So our source code is added to the project. So the first step after writing any program is to check for syntax error. So in this Keil Microvision compiler, we are going to check the syntax error by using what is known as build target function. So right click on the source code, press on build target. The shortcut is F7, build target. So at this point, you can see that it indicates the errors and the warnings. So make sure the errors are zero, because until and unless the errors are zero, you cannot proceed to the next stage. So make sure the errors are zero. After this stage, the next stage is debug start session or control F5 shortcut. At this stage, you can say OK. Now, next step is, of course, for this program, the next step is debug go. And you can see that on the left hand side in this project window, okay, we can see that the data whatever I have transferred here is copied into the accumulator. So there is the end result of our execution of the code. Okay. So that's how we can execute a simple assembly language code. After executing this code, okay, let us say I want to do another execution of another program, then you have to say debug stop session, okay, and again you can edit this code or you can delete this source code from the project. You can add another source code to the project. So that's how you can build and execute multiple source code in a given project.